Still reeling from the Game of Thrones finale last week, you're not alone. With Series 5 averaging at almost 20 million views per episode, not including the innumerable piracy downloads we've come to expect from HBO releases, the Game of Thrones fan base is continuing to grow and grow. So what makes a Game of Thrones fan? And why does it draw such a loyal, diverse, and in some respects, obsessive fan base? Join us as we delve into the world of GOT fandom.
I think it was the realisation that the whole nation was watching Game of Thrones every Monday. So you thought, if you can't beat them, join them.
My husband insisted on making me watch one episode. He said I could watch one episode. If I didn't like it, I didn't have to watch any more. But we finished the first episode and I was like, can we watch the next one, please?
We get here really early, actually. I got here at 5:30, and that's it. So it started at 9.
It's hard to recall a TV series that's inspired its fans the way Game of Thrones has. For many, enjoying the programme goes beyond simply watching it at home and discussing it on Twitter. Game of Thrones has people recreating their own banquets, throwing screening parties, and dressing up as their favourite characters at conventions. Legions of cosplayers chose Game of Thrones as their inspiration at cons such as the LSCC and MCM. We caught up with Megan, who uses the cosplayer name Briar Rose, about her enactment of Marjorie Tyrell.
I've wanted to do a Game of Thrones cosplay for absolutely ages. I've only ever cosplayed Disney characters before, so this is my first like foray into live action. And Marjorie is my absolute favourite Game of Thrones character and probably one of my favourite female characters just in general of all time. So I thought it would be nice to pay homage.
And what is it like to enjoy something so much like Game of Thrones and then to actually be in costume for it?
I think cosplaying any character from any series is just like the ultimate way to celebrate your love for it. And this is the first time that I've worn this cosplay out and about, and it's been lovely. It's been really nice.
In Dalston, East London, the Three Compasses pub is well known for its weekly screenings of Game of Thrones, which it's been putting on since the beginning of season 4. And why do you think Game of Thrones works so well as a communal event?
I think it's a very filmic programme, so it's almost like a pantomime in some ways. So when we show it, everyone, because they're such massive fans, everyone is completely silent and you could hear a pin drop in here. But then at the same time, they're all, you know, gasping and booing at the same time, you know. So I think, yeah, just it being a big filmic, cinematography and everything just works really well on the big screen as well.
They've exponentially expanded in the amount of people that have come. So like from the first one, there was maybe 20 fans to being, I think, probably about 100 people cram in here at one stage. So it was quite fun.
How many times do you think you've been to the screening at the Three Compasses?
These three and then the last series, so 13 times, probably. Yeah, that's about right, yeah.
What's it like to watch it in such a big group?
Absolutely amazing. I mean, like the ninth episode of the last one, the big fight scene at the wall, that was incredible. There's hundreds of people here, you know, someone gets axed in the head or something, and everyone's like, hey, you know. And the first episode of this series, when the character comes on, you know, Tyrion and that, you know, everyone gives the whistles and the cheers, and yeah, it's great fun. The theme tune, singing along to it, that kind of thing, yeah, it's great.
And what kind of crowd is it? I mean, is it people that are really into Game of Thrones, or is it people that are sort of coming along, having a drink, and like, oh yeah, you know, like we kind of saw this online and wanted to check it out, like, or is it a mixture?
It's a real mix. A lot of it is our regular customers who just are fans of the programme, or there's people coming from all over London, though. We get a lot of Americans calling up as well. Some people in fancy dress, but yeah. it's definitely a real mix. It's not just our normal clientele, it's people actually travelling across London to come and see it.
Evidence of the Game of Thrones party craze can be seen all over Twitter. Even San Francisco Giants player Hunter Pence threw a finale party at his home in California. So what is it that makes Game of Thrones so appealing to such a wide audience?
I think just when it first aired, it was quite different to everything else. It was full action, full drama, full everything, just full on. And I think especially in an arena like the pub, you get that a lot. And it's a bit of fantasy, something a bit different, yeah.
I think it's just, that's what happens when you have a great, sturdy, rich story and characters that are so real and relatable. I think it's things like Harry Potter and Lord of the Rings. I think Game of Thrones is a bit like that. It's just, it crosses audiences because it's just so well put together and so well made and so well thought out.
What do you think about doing it with any other programmes? Do you think there's anything like Game of Thrones that would draw people in like that?
No, because we did think that when the last season finished and we thought, right, what else should we show on a Monday? And people have bandied about different ideas. But I just don't think anything would work, really. Like, people are saying things like Breaking Bad or, you know, I just think that because they're not as filmic and it's not like something that the whole nation is watching on a Monday, I just don't think it would have the same impact. It wouldn't be the same atmosphere. Or, yeah, people suggest things like Girls, but you just like, I don't know, it just feels too much like watching a TV programme, whereas Game of Thrones, I think, has a much different feel to it. It's just because it is so filmic. So, no.
It seems that Game of Thrones has managed to transcend the boundaries of taste. It's not limited to fans of fantasy, action or grimdark. Instead, it seems to appeal to just about anyone. And with at least two more series to come, and a good handful of stars still to kill off, kind of, its fan base looks set to widen even more.